بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وبعد. Here at the Lewisham Islamic Center, we have a very clear vision of what we would like to see Islam looking like in the future in Europe and in Britain. We see that Islam has the solutions to many of the problems that we are facing today as a community and as a society, and we would like to be the catalyst to produce those solutions from home in an organic, principle-based manner. Therefore, our vision is a vision of organically growing Islam within our community and adopting the elements of British culture, which are at one with our Islamic principles, whilst refining that which may be in clash with the Islamic principles from the British culture around us. And the new generation of Muslims, of course, we are British. And so we want this Lewisham Islamic Center to be an example of that. We want to be a center which pushes Islam forward and which leads the Muslims into the new age of what we are seeing around us today. Islam has always been a center point within the countries that Islam enters into. We look to Africa, we look to the Middle East, we look to Asia, and we look to any land that Islam has entered into, and we find that once Islam takes root in the land, Islam refines, Islam develops, Islam cultivates, Islam produces, and Islam educates. And that's what we want to do here. We want to be the catalysts of change, and we want to be the catalysts of education and refinement. We want to help our fellow man to reach the pinnacles and peaks that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, our Lord, has written for us and has enabled us to achieve and to reach. The difference between us as men and the beasts is that we can educate ourselves, we can refine ourselves, we can learn, we can develop. And in order to do so, we have to have a framework from which we base our development and our education and our refinement. And that is what we want to provide as Muslims in the UK, British Muslims, and more so as the potential future leaders of Muslims, as imams and young teachers here at Lewisham Islamic Center. That is our vision and that is our goal. And to do that, we want to utilize our hefty and large chest of traditions that has been left for us by our scholars of the past, our heritage, our traditions, and we want to bring those traditions into this era that we're living in a natural and organic way, as was previously stated. And what does that mean? It means understanding the principles of Islam and applying them to the context and applying them to our circumstances. And we can find an example of this when we look globally around the world, when we look to Africa, when we look to the Middle East, and when we look to Asia. We will find that the principles are shared principles, the values are common values, but the adaptation or the implementation of those principles differ. So you'll find a basic example when we look to the clothing, when we look to the food, when we look to the greetings that people use in those lands and those places. They are very, very similar. For example, the Muslim greeting is a greeting of peace, a greeting of love, a greeting of warmth, but it differs in the way that it's carried out within those lands. Likewise, you'll find that one of the common shared principles and values of Islam is to be charitable. And so you'll find various charitable means of practice in those lands, but they look slightly different. You'll find that from the principles of Islam is that a man dignifies himself in the way that he dresses. A woman dignifies herself in the way that she dresses. But you will find that in those lands, the medium of dignification, the medium of clothing is different, but they share in the underlying principles and values of covering the private parts and looking honorable and dignified. So what we want to do and what we are pushing here at Lewisham Islamic Center is to allow that space for European British Islam to grow organically based upon our principles, traditions, and within the realms of our context and our circumstance.